It's Sara, and I'm back today to paint these little angels, which I love. This is a free pattern on artistclub.com, and I'll put the link in the description box for you to go over and download or just print your copy of the pattern so that you can paint along with me. And here are my little ornaments. They are so cute. Artist Club also provides you with the surface, which are, let me see, they're just little ornaments, but, so here it says Christmas holiday ornaments, and it has the number 80810, and I don't remember how much they were. My hubby actually cut them for me out of some wood. I went to Michael's and I bought two hearts, and they were just like this kind of a little heart, like that. And then I traced the shape, so it's the really thin chipboard. Traced the shapes on there, and Joe cut them out. I then, on the, because I really, really love the birdhouse, and I just added stickles to these, so yeah, it's dry. But I really love the birdhouse, so I ended up getting, I had this little pack of their wood skinny sticks, but they're like this, the kind that are stirrers. They're like popsicle sticks, but they're thin. And I just cut these, and I actually used my Tim Holtz scissors and just cut them, and I glued them into place and made it look like a little birdhouse. And I did that on these. Now this was different wood. You can see that it's a totally actually, this wood was something that I had in my stash. It was actually shaped like a star, but he cut these three out for me. But then when I wanted more, I just went and bought those, so it's much thinner. And I did the same thing. I glued, the stickles isn't quite dry. I glued these little popsicle sticks to the houses. And I used Weld Bond, which is the glue that I use. It's right here. For when I do my mosaics, it's a white glue, but it's very strong. But you could use whatever your favorite adhesive is. And I made these little ornaments. So I'm going to show you now how to prep your wood and get ready to paint them. Here, I'll zoom in. They are super cute. This pattern is by Deb Antonak, or Nick Antonak, and I wish I knew how to pronounce it. Yeah. So. And I really, really liked it because the wings are actually, there's words on the wings. So we're going to cut those out and use book pages, which I actually am going to use something else that I've had in my stash. This is by Christy Tomlinson, the She Art Word Text. And this is kind of like on a tissue paper. And this was my last piece, and I'm so glad I found it, but I'm using it very sparingly. But I actually, you're just going to trace out the wing shape and glue it onto your little ornament. And then I haven't added my hangers yet, but I just did the three shapes. They're super simple, guys, and I love these so much. I love these more than the little Halloween one. I'm uploading that now, but all right. So the first thing you're going to need is whatever you're painting on. And like I said in the other one, you can just paint these. If you have the pattern, you can trace, or you can just freehand it and wing it. These are very easy shapes. It's not, but I like having the pattern when you're putting it on a surface because it's going to fit exactly onto the surface. And so I have these little shapes, and I'm going to first, you have to seal the wood. But the way I like to do it, I use this all-purpose sealer, and the other thing I like about these patterns is they give you a whole list of all your supplies, the paint colors, which I am not using. I had very few of these colors. Whoops, I'm so sorry. So I just picked close enough colors. I kind of just looked at the pictures and picked my colors. The surface. The other thing she uses, which she used crackle paste, and I don't have the crackle paste. I may pick some up because I'd like to try it, but it's the DecoArt Media crackle paste, and I didn't have it. I have other crackle, but I didn't crackle these at all. I just went without the crackle, so mine are just smooth. She also used the Ultra Fine writer tip, and I happen to have one, so I broke mine out. I'd never used it before, and I used it on this project, which was awesome. You don't need it, but there are a few, so they list all the supplies, even the brushes that she uses. Then she gives tips and techniques for dry brushing, which is her the way she likes to highlight. And so everything is right there for you, and I'm just going to take you through and do it the way I paint. So the first thing you're going to do, we're going to prep this wood, and to do that we need to make it poreless. It's porous now, which means the paint will just suck into the wood, but we're going to make it solid surface. So I'm using my sealer, my all-purpose sealer, and I'm also going to mix it with the base colors that I'm going to use. So it's going to be a blue house, a yellow star, and a pink heart. So that makes sense. So I'm just going to take a little bit of pink. My paints are very old. I have to poke a little hole in here. But if you shake them up, just make sure you shake it, you'll get the proper mixture out. So that's that. A little bit of yellow. And I'm just using a paper plate for now. I like to use my wax palette, which I'll show you once I get going with that. But when I'm doing prep, this is my least favorite part. I don't like doing prep at all. And you see, I'm just putting out a little bit of paint. I'm going to use, like, not my nicest brushes, like, this is kind of roughed up. I'll probably use this for all of them, and then I'll go clean my water. But I like to take, so we're going to do the house first. I like to take the color and a little bit of the sealer and mix it together. So I'm sealing the piece, but I'm also putting some of the color into the wood as well, and then when I sand it, it just kind of seals it with the color on the piece. And this color I'm using happens to be called Soft Blue. And I know Deb used a different color. I'm going to need more paint. I don't know why I put out so little paint. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do this to all my pieces. I'm going to mix a little dime spot of sealer. I'll show you. I always say that. And I'm going to put this all over the piece. So I need a little more. Maybe a nickel. Do a nickel. I'm trying not to waste paint, but I'm a waster anyway. But you mix it like 1-to-1. That's all. And I just brush mix it. You don't have to be perfect. But I'm going to do both sides, because we're going to sand this. When this is dry, it will bring the tooth of the wood back up, so it won't be smooth. I've already sanded it gently, but nothing major. But I want to cover this whole piece, all the wood, with this mixture of sealer and paint. And then let it dry thoroughly. So I'll go away, I'll do all of the pieces, and I'll come back when it's all dry and show you the next step. So I just like to get it smooth. I don't want to have any ridges. I don't like ridges, but it's not going to hurt anything if there's ridges. But that is filled, that's covered. So I'm going to let it dry. I have my fan on. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to do the other two, and I'll be right back when they're dry. Okay, so they're dry. I've sanded these two, but I want to show you, I'm just using a fine sandpaper, and you don't need to kill it. It's fine. Just gently, and I would do this over my trash can, just get the little tooth that comes back up when you, like, maybe it's the sealer that, like, I think paint does it too, but it'll take that little tooth right off, and then you'll have a nice smooth surface. And I do the edges, and they're little ornaments, so you don't have to knock yourself out with this. It's not like it's a showpiece, you know. And your wood may have knots in it, so try to get a good piece of wood. Alright. Then, before you trace your pattern on, I'm going to use this side. I'm going to put another coat, just a thin coat, on the ornament. And I like to add a little bit of water, so I have water in my brush. Let's see where I am here. I'll load my brush. I probably need more paint. And, oopsie. Just really smooth. Just smooth. The wetter the paint, the smoother it'll go on. There's a little booger in there. Paint booger, I call them. It's when the paint hardens in it. So I'm adding a little more water to my brush because I want it to smooth on there. You don't need this to be thick. I like it thin. Two thin coats. And there you have it. So now it's opaque. I have no, what are they called? Ridges, right? So I'm going to do that to all three of these with just straight paint this time. This time it's just paint and water. No more sealer. This is sealed. So we're just going in, and that was a little thick, so I'm just going to add a little. I'm just touching into water because the paint, I have the fan on and the paint's sitting there, and acrylic paint dries pretty fast. So it just gets a little skin on it, so you just have to add a little water to your brush to get it to thin out a little bit. Because like I said, I like two thin coats rather than one thick gloppy coat. And this is the front because I have a little eave under my roof. And I'm going to do the top of the roof too. I think I'll hold it by the edge here and I'll do the top of the roof and the base. And then I'll get the back in a minute. I don't need the back right now. I'll come back and actually I just did the backs of the three ornaments that I had previously done. I just sanded them a little bit and I just painted the back. And then I wrote my name and sealed it with a varnish. So you can do that at the end. But I do want to kind of get the edges. Alright, so that's ready to go. Gotta let it dry. And then I'm gonna let all these dry. And I like to work on all three at one time. And what's great about this pattern is all of the ornaments use the same colors. So like her dress is the same color as this ornament, and that dress is the same color as that ornament, and this dress is the same color. So it's really easy. You're not working with a lot of different colors. So I'm going to come back when I'm ready to put the pattern on. Okay, so they're dry. This is the second coat. I'm gently just taking that little bit of tooth off the piece. So that is smooth now, okay? So set those aside. The next thing you want to do is get your pattern ready. And I have tracing paper here, the pattern itself, and graphite paper. And I guess this is considered gray graphite. I'm not sure because it's dark in color. I want to make sure I have it going the right way, because if you do it this way, nothing happens. If you do it this way, good. Alright, so first thing I do is take this and I just trace it on with a pencil. So I just take tracing paper and I go over. You don't need a light box, you can see it well enough. And just trace on all the, where's my pencil, all the marks. I usually, when I trace a pattern, I trace everything that I'm going to want to use later on. Now, that being said, I see here that I did not trace everything at all. I didn't trace these little hearts because I can make a heart without using a tracing. So I just freehanded all that stuff. mainly I just have the main pattern lines on here. So like even on this one, there's a couple different, even on the little chicken, she's holding a chicken. I didn't trace the tail feathers or the little beak because I can add that myself. So you guys, if you feel like it, you need to trace everything because you're, you know, unsure or don't know, then I would suggest tracing everything so you have it. Then you set those aside. Well, then when you're ready to put your pattern on, you're going to take your piece and you line up your pattern with the tracing paper and you line it up on the piece. So I'll zoom in a little bit so you can see this a little better. So I've got it centered on here pretty much. So I know the whole angel is going to be on the piece. So I'm going to take my tracing paper and slide it between the wood piece and the angel. Now I'm holding my finger here so the tracing, so this doesn't move. Then you want to hold it pretty solid in place. I'm using a stylus. You can use a pencil, you can use a pen, anything with a pointy tip that can press down and then the pattern. Now, I'm not going to put her arms on yet or the heart. I'm going to, and I'll tell you why in a second. Her head is really big and I'm kind of changing the shape because it doesn't need to be. I'm going to put the wings on though. And I'll put those little hearts too. What the heck? Oh, well, that one I can't. And that one. And I said I can't because there we go. Graphite was not under the design. Okay, so all we have now is the main design. And actually, I didn't put a little neck. Her little neck. And I'm going to do all three. I'm going to trace the pattern on all three. Now, the reason I didn't put all the arms and the little chicken, was it? I don't even know which one was on. Oh, the heart. Is because it's easier to paint those on. Actually, yeah. We're going to paint the dress first. So I'm going to go ahead and trace all of these on, and I'll be right back. Okay, I want to keep everything that I come across, I'm just going to keep telling you. So on the, for some reason, on the first one I did too, I just noticed that she was down a little far. There was just a lot of room up there, so I just moved her up. I don't know why, and it's going to be fine. The other thing was I kind of overlapped a little bit on some of the tracings. So I'll just erase it, and it's actually really dark, my tracing, which... I don't love when the graphite lines come out so dark, but in this case, it's fine. In every case, it's fine, because graphite is erasable. But see how she, I just moved her up a little, and there's still going to be enough room. I just felt like it. All right, so now all my patterns are traced on. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to trace the wings onto the paper that I showed you in the beginning, the word paper, and this happens to be by Christy Tomlinson, She Art Coffee Filter Sheets Text. And it just says girl stuff. She didn't care if it was perfect. She loved the simple things. She remembered the good years. She wanted to learn every day. She knew it. So good she stuff. And I'm really trying to save it, so I'm taking care to only, I'm using it up very sparingly. So I'm going to take my wings over here. Let's see if you can see what I'm doing. So I'm making sure that my wings are on the paper. So the top of the paper is like right here. And I'm trying to just use it up. So I just move this up so that I get the most of it. Now, I'm going to take this tracing paper. I'm sorry, this is the graphite paper. This is the tracing paper. Make sure it's going the right way and slip it between the tracing paper and the... Oh, I moved it. but you want to trace the wings only onto a piece of word text, a piece of text paper. See, that's upside down. I knew it was upside down. There we go. So I'm going to hold this right here on her head and stick it between and trace the wing. So I'm tracing one wing first. Because we're going to cut these out, you want to get the whole wing, and then I have to readjust. Oh boy, I moved it again. Sorry if my head's in the shot, but I'm going to, this time I can just hold it on this side. You can tape it down or whatever. I just try to do it as easy as possible, keep it as easy as I can, and we're going to cut that out. So you want to make sure that, all right, so you can see it. So there's pencil line. It's that graphite line. So I would do that with all three sets of wings. So this one is for, which one is this? The heart. So I'm going to cut these out. And I would do that with all three of the wings. I'm going to cut them out, totally cut them out. But I just wanted to have you do that and set them aside with each of your, so I need to do this one. So I'm going to do this one. I'm just pushing the wings up to the edge of the paper so that I use, as I don't want to waste it, is what I'm trying to do. Alright, so I'll be right back when that's done. Okay, so I have them all. They're not completely cut out yet because I didn't want them blowing all around. But I forgot one thing. We're going to shade. So we're going to the directions. So if you open your directions, first page has the preparation. So we've base coated the ornaments in the star, the heart, and the birdhouse, and we've traced on the patterns. Now we're going to shade each ornament around the design, right? So the star in mustard seed, the heart in watermelon slice, and the birdhouse in peacock teal. I don't have either of any of those colors, but I will just show you what I'm going to use for. I'm going to try the antique gold. Yeah, I like the antique gold. So instead of mustard seed, I'm going to use antique gold. I think that's a nice transition. We'll see. Because I changed the colors a little bit from when I first did it. This is Indian turquoise. I'm going to shade this color, which I'm using soft blue, with the Indian turquoise. And then for the sachet pink, I'm going to use antique mauve. So I'm going to shade the pink with this color. And hopefully it'll give a nice contrast and just give us some depth. Now, I like to use my little floating technique when I shade or highlight. Well, actually, we're going to dry brush for highlighting in this. I'm going to use my palette paper. So I'm coming in a little bit here. I should probably change my water, but I'll do that in a second. I'm going to use my bigger brush now. For shading, I like to use an angle brush, and that just means that it's a flat bristle, but it's been cut at an angle. So sometimes you'll have a shader, which is just a flat brush like this, and it's cut straight across. An angle brush, they just cut it on an angle. And I, for some reason, I just like using that to flute with. So I'm in my water bucket right now, and I always use water. So let me get some paint. Let's do this. Let's do the heart first. I just feel like using, and I don't know, I could do all these on camera because I think the more you see it, the better. But here's, I'm putting out a little bit of this antique mauve. I have my brush. I'm going into the water. I am blotting it on a paper towel. I pick up a little bit of paint on the corner, that little pointy corner. And I'm a heavy hand, so I tend to go a lot heavier, but I'm trying to keep it soft. And you're going to press the bristles down onto this, and this is a painter's palette. What's it called? Palette paper, sorry. It's like a waxy surface, and you can see that it goes from dark to light to water. And I'm going to go to the piece with this. I also am going to use a mop brush if need be, and this stays dry, but I'll show you what you want to do. I put the color up against the edge of the piece, so the color was up against my little girl. I'm going to go on water, blot, paint, load. I do that, I just keep doing it over and over and over to load my brush. When I feel like I have too much water, I blot. When I feel like there's not enough, I'll get more water. So I'm going to start right here this time. Stick the paint in the corner there, and I'm pushing up against the wing. All the bristles are on the surface. So because it's a slanted brush, you have to make sure you have as many. Well, I'm going around a corner, so I can't have all the bristles on the surface, but as many bristles as you can on the surface. And the mop brush is just to kind of soften the edge, but if your brush is loaded well, you don't always need to use your mop. So I'm just doing the same thing. I'm loading it right back in that same spot. I have water and paint right there, so if I need it, I can just go right back and get it there. I'm sticking the corner of my brush up against the wing. All the bristles are on the surface, and I pull the color around the design. I'm just going to pick up a little more water because I do have the fan on and it's kind of drying the surface. I'm going to go around her head. I'll reload again. Water, blot, paint, and just push the bristles down. Let's go around her head this time. And you kind of skip around the piece so that you don't pick up what you just put down. You want it to kind of be dry before you stick the brush in. So now you can see that there's kind of a shading from around the whole piece. I'm going to go above too. I'm going to go, but that's kind of wet, so I'm going to switch it out and we'll go with the blue. I'm just going to put that on top of my wings. I'll come back and add it in a minute. And I'm going to do the same thing with this blue color, which I'm Indian turquoise. Rinsing my brush off, blot, corner of Indian turquoise, and I put the paint down and walk away from it if I feel like it's too intense. Keep pushing it into that puddle until I like the graduation of color. And I'm going to go down the side of the dress first. I don't even know if this is a good color to shade with. It looks good. And we're going to go around the head. Hopefully I'm in the shot. I want all the bristles to be on the surface because you need the water as well. But because the roof is there, my brush is kind of big. But that's good. And then I would just take, if you're using a mop, you just want to touch the water's edge and just kind of soften it out a little bit. I'm going to tuck this up against this side of the body. And a little bit around this wing. It's hard to get in there, so I'm just kind of fudging it because the roof is in the way. But you can see how that is shining from behind. So where's my wings? Uh-oh. Here they are. And then I'll do the same thing one more time with the yellow. I'm going to use this antique gold. Blot the excess water out, corner load, and start to push the paint into the bristles. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to go around this piece. Basically, this is just the top. Well, we'll go around the head. And I have to see if it's even going to show up because I didn't have mustard seed. I could use raw sienna maybe. It's a very slight difference. I might end up using raw sienna. Do I have it out here? Here's raw sienna. I think this looks okay. Maybe it's not as drastic a change, but I think it's good enough. I don't know if I want it to be that drastic. Can you see it? Yeah, I think you can see it. All right, now that we've done that, we're going to cut our wings out and we're going to adhere them to the piece. You know what? First, let me take, I just want to take a little of this pink and pull it around the top edge. For some reason, I can't get the... I think it's because the fan is like blowing right on my paint and it's like drying it so fast. But I just wanted to put a little color on the tip of the heart. I think I want to put a little bit under the roof in the blue. So, right up under the roof, down the side. Up that way. So my camera just said task in progress and the screen went black, so I'm really hoping that all that shading was in the video, because I mean I did a really good job. So basically I just am going to finish up this little what is it called, a star, corner loading my brush, going from dark to light to water. And then I'm just going to put a little bit on the tip of the star here, and here, and here. Love it, love it, love it, love it. All right, I'm going to set this aside. And I need to cut out now my wings, which I got them all discombobulated. This one goes here. This one, I believe, goes there, and this one there. So I'm going to cut them out, and I'll be right back. You're going to need your matte medium. We're going to adhere the wings to the piece with matte medium, all right? So I'll be right back. Okay, I have them all cut out. Now, here's the thing. I wasn't following the directions, so let's just back up a second. Back it on up. So it said to shade though, see? It did. All right, I didn't do anything wrong. All angels, wings. Trace and cut out the wings from the white text decoupage paper. And actually, in the over here, there must be some type of decoupage paper that Artist Club supplies. Oh, it says decoupage paper, vintage silhouette, number 820, whatever. They may supply it too. So if you want to order that, go ahead and order it. But, so I traced and cut out my wings, and I'm going to put them on now with matte medium. Quickly lay the paper wings onto the surface and smooth into place with the brush and let dry. Okay, but here's one thing I want to tell you. I mean, I am going to do this, and I mean, when I cut them out, my cutting may not be as perfect as I draw them. And I use my lovely Cutterbee scissors, which I love. They're EK Success. But anyway, I am just going to erase, and remember I said, and actually because we shaded all around it too, I'm going to erase these tracing lines so that if I haven't cut my wings exactly to the shape, at least, oops, I just blew everything, it'll be close enough. Because I shaded around everything, I have an idea of where they go. This one and this one. Alright, so I'm going to get some matte medium over here, and I have a brush. What brush do I want to use? I think I want to use, I have like a little round brush. That'll be fine. This is like a number, I bet it's like a number 4. So I'm just going to put a little bit of this out on this paper plate. Maybe I'll change paper plates. And just put a little bit of this out. I'm going to just go, let's zoom in. I'm going to pull my camera. I do this all the time, but I can reach it with my feet. I want to pull it a little closer because my tripod's across from me over there. All right, this is a little better. Yeah, I like it better this way. So I'm going to take my matte medium, and I'm just going to put it in the wing area, right where the wing is going to go. So basically just paint my little shape of my wing on there. And I can still see the tracing lines. Then I'm going to take my wing. I'm going to line it up at the top here because I think that's what I want to be more exact. And I'm going to just go over it and get it stuck down. Do the same thing on this side. Do the same thing. I'm going to stick it the ends first, I think. And there you go. But now it doesn't, I don't need to worry that those dark lines are going to show up underneath it or behind it. Alright. I don't like it right there. I think I'm going to try and cut that off. No, I cut it a little too much, but that's okay. Gonna set it aside to dry, and I'm gonna do that with all of my little angels. I'm gonna erase these lines just so they don't stick out. But I still have placement. So hopefully I'm in the shot. So the Eagles game, it's Sunday, and the Eagles are actually winning. Let's see. Yep, 10-0. They're beating Pittsburgh. I'm on the Wentz wagon. I like this kid. He's doing fantastic. We've watched all the games this year so far, and it's exciting. We've had such crappy seasons, the last couple seasons, that it's kind of, it's exciting when they're doing well. Oopsie, get back on there, you. So yeah, I have it muted in the background. I'm going to take a break after this and go watch with Joe. And then I'm just going right over it. And if you have Mod Podge, you could use Mod Podge to do this. I'm sure it would be fine. I would just use a mat, and it doesn't even matter because we're going to add stickles, which she adds something different. But I love the way hers turned out too. And what's cool about this pattern is she shows such a detailed picture. So you really get a good idea of what it looks like. So you don't have to guess, and you don't have to wonder if you're doing it right, because you can just really look at the picture and... Even color-wise, it was nice because I didn't have the colors that she was using. My colors are old, and I think they've added a few colors to the DecoArt line now. And so I just used what I have a conversion book too, but I don't get as caught up in it as I used to. And some projects, though, it really would make a difference if you didn't have the right colors. But when it's just a cutesy, sweet piece like this, I don't think the angels would mind if I put their wings, you know, or made their dress a little different color, you know. So I did it what I had. I used what I had. And that's what I want you guys to do too. That's a little off. Yeah, I want to get a t-shirt for Carson Wentz. We're on the Wentz wagon. It's getting full. Alright, so I want to get this stuck on there. I fudged that one around a lot. I couldn't get it on straight for some reason. And I kind of like this tissue paper too, because it really absorbs the matte medium really nice. So I'm curious what the paper is that she used, what kind of collage paper it is. But all right, so we have all that. I'm gonna clean my brush. We've got it looking like that so far. And then the next thing on the directions is to make their faces and stuff. Oh, it says the base over the wings with a wash of light buttermilk, but we have to wait until they dry. But while they're drying, we can do the next step, which says heads and hands. Base coat with mocha and shade with burnt sienna. Now, we don't have our hands on here yet, but we can base our dresses. How about we do that? The dress on the star is the pink. The dress on the heart is the blue. Oh, I don't know what I'm doing. And then the dress on the blue would be the yellow. So that's just, again, it's going to be two coats of color. I want to take a break though. I think I'm going to come back. You know what? I'll do it while it's on. It's all right. It's the first quarter. So we're going to get these, the base colors back out again, the light colors. So for me, it's these pink sachet, moon yellow, and soft blue. And I'll probably use that same little brush that I just used for the matte medium. And I probably could have used my old puddles too. And refer to your pictures too. I always have the picture handy right in front of me, so I can refer to that, so I can just look up and know what color to use. So on the star, it's going to be the pink. And when I load my brush, I push the brush down into the paint. I have water in the bristles, first of all, not dripping. I always blot first. But now I make a little smoother, wetter puddle next to the actual puddle of paint so that it's a little slicker and smoother, and it's going to go down a little easier. And I'm going to make a collar. I kind of made a little rounded mark. And just fill this in, because we're going to trace on the arms and the little, what's he holding, the snowman? Yeah. So see how you can kind of see the yellow peeking through. But we're going to do a second coat on that. So I'm going to set that aside and let it dry. And the heart is going to be the blue. This dress is going to be blue. Again, water, blot. Make a slicker, wetter puddle next to that puddle, so that I just don't scoop that up and start going. I'd rather have two thin coats than one thick coat. Making a little collar area there. You can always touch up the edges if you get paint on the edges or stuff like that. I went on the wing, but that's okay. I'm going to set that aside to dry. And then this little guy is yellow. Making a slicker, wetter puddle. I actually left my neck on this one so I can see where I'm going with it. When I trace the arms on, I can put the neck back on and the and fix it if it doesn't look right. And you just want it to be opaque. It doesn't have to be, well, it's a light color. What am I trying to say? But yeah, I like mine to be opaque. I don't really want to be able to see the color through there like this. Like, see how you can see the pink shining through the blue? So we're going to let those dry. This kind of looks weird, like the head is... I'm going to have to paint over that. I think my, you know what, I'm going to use my paint, my heat gun, and just make sure the matte medium is dry, and then we can put a little wash of white on top. This thing gets hot, man. If your fingers are in the way. Ouch, burns. Just wanted to speed it up because it said to put a wash of, was it warm white? Oh man. Light buttermilk. So I have, and I think I have light buttermilk. Where are ya? Yeah, I have light buttermilk. DecoArt light buttermilk, and I'm going to, when you make a wash, it is, I'm using that same brush again. It is water. Mostly water, and my water is disgusting right now. It's very dirty. I'm gonna have to clean that. So I've dipped in the water, and I have a lot of water on my brush, and I'm just pulling some of that paint into the water because you want it to be mostly water, not very much paint. More water than paint. So I have a wash right here, and I'm rinsing my brush. I don't want to use the brush after I've made the wash. I want to rinse it and then go into that puddle and use this wash to paint over the wings. And it should dry thin and like really light. So I'm gonna let it do that. And because on my very first one I did, I actually blotted. If you feel like your wash is too opaque, but see, it's getting sheer. It's turning sheer. So just go ahead, and I'm going to add a little bit more water to my brush and just go over the whole wing with a sheer wash of light buttermilk and let it dry. Don't play with it. Don't piddle in it. Because you'll pick it up once it starts to dry, and you'll put a hole in it, and it won't look as consistent like the, you know, like it would if you hadn't picked it up. So I made enough to go all three sets of wings. And that is done. So yeah, this wing looks kind of weird. I'm going to put, the head will be there. It'll be fine. There'll be hair. There'll be all types of stuff. It'll be great. So now I'm going to go back, and I'm going to do a second coat water. I don't know where the camera is. Hold on. Water, blot, make a thinner, wetter puddle. So I don't want thick paint. I want it to move so I have water in it. It's not a wash. There's more paint than there is water, but I want it to move. I want to put it down and have it go spread out where I want it pretty evenly, pretty quickly, and that's it. And you're done. You don't have to take too much time. So that's done. You can tell that it's opaque now. It's not going to have the color, the behind color, the blue in this case, showing through. So we're going to do yellow. And I'm just loading my brush with water and paint. And I'm just going to put it down. Use the brush to get it in the nooks and crannies. Use the edge of the brush to create a straight line. I like to use flat brushes to base coat a lot. I tend to use flat brushes more often. I'm just, because this is so tiny, these pieces are really tiny, I am just using this round brush because it's easier to get in those little nooks and crannies. And you can flatten a round brush out. So that is done right there. Nice and opaque. And then last but not least, this blue. And I'm going to pull that paint. See, it gets a little crust on it, a little film, because I have a fan on and acrylic paint dries really fast. So I make a little slicker, wetter puddle next to that puddle. And I'm just going to fill this in. Just pull your brush right off the edge and it'll make a nice clean edge. I don't want any rolls of paint, or what are they called? Like a paint roll or whatever. So I'm going to let those dry. And then we're going to trace our the rest of the pattern on there. They're getting there. We're about halfway there. All right, so I'll be back.